As the legislative session draws to a close, lawmakers are making major changes to a controversial bill that would relax some protections for Indiana's diminishing wetlands. As Adam Pinsker reports, removing those protections could cause serious harm to the ecosystem.
Just a few miles west of Bloomington lies Bean Blossom Bottoms Nature Preserve. If you take a stroll along its boardwalk, you may see species of birds and other animals unique to the area.
Bean Blossom Bottoms is a great place in the summer to see Prothonotary warblers, which are a migratory bird. They come up here during the summer to breed.
John Lawrence heads up the Sycamore Land Trust, which purchases land and easements, which it then restores and protects, such as Bean Blossom Bottoms, one of the dwindling patches of wetland areas throughout southern and central Indiana.
I know we have lost since European settlement, you know, roughly 80-90% of the wetlands that that used to be here.
The area is critical to the animals and plants that use them, as well as humans.
We all really rely on water, and wetlands are just serve such an important function in water storage, reducing flooding, cleaning groundwater by filtering out pollutants.
But a bill proposed by State Senator Chris Garten would eliminate a 2003 law that requires the Indiana Department of Environmental Management to issue permits in a state-regulated wetland and enforce violations of those permits against landowners. Proponents say the legislation streamlines unnecessary regulations that deter development and drive up the cost of housing. But Democrats and even some Republicans say lifting the restrictions would jeopardize these protected ecosystems.
You know, these areas are just critical to the animals and plants that utilize them.
On Wednesday, the House Environmental Affairs Committee made several changes to the bill, including one that no longer excludes classes of wetlands from permitting requirements. The amendments also exclude croplands and temporary streams from being categorized as wetlands.
Rather than trying to take a meat cleaver to this, we were a little more surgical.
The amended bill passed the committee unanimously, but some members aren't happy with the changes and say they might vote against the bill in the full House.
Senate Bill 389 in its original form, I believe, was a much stronger bill, a better bill. IDEM is an agency that has been out of control, and we need to make sure we rein them in.
Senator Garten's staff said he was unavailable for an interview but provided us with this statement. I appreciate all the work Chairman Gutwein and the House Environmental Affairs Committee have invested into the important issues Senate Bill 389 aims to address. I am currently educating myself on how the adopted amendment would apply to and affect our regulated community, our environment, and the Indiana Department of Environmental Management. I am encouraged that all authors, sponsors, and co-sponsors of this bill are committed to drafting a finished piece of legislation that creates a fair and equitable wetland statute that continues to recognize and protect Indiana's natural resources. Lawrence sees this debate as a chance to emphasize the importance of preserving the state's wetlands before they are gone.
Maybe more education, spreading the word on why it's important to protect wetlands, not lose the ones that we have. Hopefully that will maybe change things in another direction.
For Indiana News Desk, I'm Adam Pinsker.